it's a visceral response to the music, and then the visual creative response of the paint flying is it's hard to resist.
The Paint Drums, copyright 2018, 3rd Street Theater, New York City, Randall James Blumer Group. The Paint Drums themselves they're very visceral. They're sort of like if you take the notion of spectacular and spectacle and put it down into a grounded sort of primal exercise, that's what they are.
You know, we wanted to express something about tribalism. We wanted to express something at the same time about the creative impulse, you know, and it seemed like if we were trying to create this indigenous tribe called Blue Man, that the drums would be sort of special purpose, or that they would feel like they were homemade in some way. We went to the hardware store and found out about this wood called wiggle wood that you can, you know, fashion into a circle. It was fun to think about a practical use for pi. You know, we had to use pi to calculate curvature of these drums, because it would be one piece of wood and we would curl it up and then find a way to make the scene come together, you know, and we had to make it to, we just used drum hardware that was available at drum stores, and they ended up, partly by convenience, they sort of ended up looking both recognizable and indigenous at the same time, if that makes any sense, because the drum hardware looks like from our world, but the kind of length of them made them look like they were, you know, something special or something unique and not just a typical drum kit. We just set out to build them first, and the comedy, the drama, all of that will come afterwards, you know. Nobody really sat down at a desk and sort of wrote that piece the way it exists now.
I would say the biggest secret about the paint drums, and something that's interesting to me technically, is on the base of the paint drums there are pneumatic pedals which let out a burst of air that goes inside the drum, and there's a little bit of there's an electrical switch that either turns on the light or turns on the pump.
It's very unique to our experience here. Those kind of switches in particular, and using the pedals, that's not something you're necessarily going to find elsewhere in the regular theater world.
Inside you can see our uplight. Our uplight there is to actually uplight the performers as well as the paint when it is happening during the finale. And our switch is right here, our pedal. And when we step on the pedal, we turn on the light inside, and that is how the Blue Men are able to control their own light. Here we have one of our paint pumps that is used in the show. And you can see when we put it inside, we have our pedal here. And when we activate the pedal, that is what helps turn on the flow of the paint.
The paint itself, I think it's remained pretty much the same since the beginning. Tempera paint was used because it was safe and it could be mixed with water and it was readily available and not so expensive and it could wash out.
So this paint, the paint that goes up on the drums, since they need a drum with it, we water it down from the thick tempera paint so that it is able to move and be vibrant on the drum. And mixing the paint, it's always a balance of needs to be dark enough to stick to a canvas or to read on the drum, but needs to be light enough that it's able to be aerated and is able to fly around and is able to go everywhere.
It's almost like a call and response. It's like echolocation, and there's a mystery. There's something out there. We're in some unknown realm, and this is our best way of sort of figuring out what's going on. There's so many things you have to think about. In multiple pieces of the show, we're sort of in control of things behind the scenes without anybody really knowing what's going on. And in paint drumming, that has to do with the foot pedals, right? So we have foot pedal in paint drumming and drum finale. We have lights. We have one pedal for the light, one pedal for the paint to come out. And in the beginning, it's a little nerve-wracking. It's how do we coordinate these? How does this happen? And you think about it a little bit and you might mess up. But yeah, after a certain amount of time, it's not about that anymore.
Paint smells, it drips on you. You're sweating from the beginning of the show, so it's already mixed with your own sweat. Not to get too pheromonally valued here, but it's true, you know. Everything starts to be liquid and you're moving forward, and it's a very tactile experience. Somehow, either people didn't tell me, or more likely I didn't listen, that the paint is really slippery. My first time ever playing the middle Roland's paint drumming, I was drumming away, it was all good until the paint came, which I'd never worked with, you know, never practiced once, and it's thick, viscous, and oily. Hit my stick, whew, stick went flying 40 feet in the air. I had one stick to do the double sticking pattern, which is a, you know, and so I was going, and it was, you know, as you can imagine, spectacularly unspectacular to do it that way, and I still had to finish the piece.
Beginning of the show is that call and response, right? Trying to figure out what's out there. And the end of the show is the culmination, it's the finale. You know, it's literally, we name it drum finale. They're like the bookends of the show. The inquisitive, what the hell is going on? And then at the end, it's, this is f***ing awesome, you know? Like, we just had a great time.
The display of life force, you see these big splashes of color right in front of the characters as they're communicating to you, and it's just an image that you don't see very often and that you don't forget.
Sets up the entire production. What you're going to see, it kind of sets the tone. It's very disarming, if anything, because, you know, the way that it starts with the screen drumming, and then the screen kind of comes up and the Blue Men are just standing there, and there's this kind of, you know, awkward exchange between the Blue Men and the audience.
I think it's just drums themselves are so primal. The bass, the rumble, the sound of it is just so instinctually driving and energetic that, for me at least, you can't help but get into that. You can't help but get into that sound.
The concept of the show is you've got two tribes. You've got the Blue Man tribe meeting the human audience tribe for the first time. And every piece in the show is a different experiment so that the tribes can meet and get to know each other together and hopefully become one by the end.
If the Blue Men are tight with each other and listening to each other, especially in drum finale as they move quickly from drum to drum, you can sit in the audience and feel that that evening is a special performance, and that's where we're striving to get to. It's a visceral response to the music, and then the visual creative response of the paint flying it's hard to resist.
Experience the magic of paint drumming. Can we add this? Can I have just at least one of these in, please, for me?
Absolutely.
Thank you for subscribing and watching, and or watching, then subscribing. Press the button. Get more. Interviews, fun, and secrets.